out to the world. We say, hey world, we need to, as artists, we need to, and non-artists, we need to be making something that contributes to and engages in larger dialogue. And so then everyone else, anyone, is invited to then join us in the next two steps. The first step is a meeting held at a central public location, central in New York State, the New York State organization. And anyone can come to that meeting, and we structured it in such a way so that everyone has a voice, to talk about why they felt compelled to show up and respond to this question, and also a voice to talk about how they feel a massive body of massive participants might best respond. And so you can think of it as a canvassing or a crowdsourcing, it's a dialogue. And then we as REAP leaders step back from that dialogue and create a rubric, a performance that pleases us aesthetically, but that engages the multiplicity of voices. So within the politics of the participant is that we do have a point of view on the dialogue, but we want to be able to create a performance that will hold multiple points of view inside of it. So then the third step is the actual performance. The actual performance involves both the rehearsal and then performing in front of the audience. So for example, in the Trayvon Martin piece, we decided to do our piece in Times Square at 10:45 p.m. when the majority of theater performances were letting out. We thought we would reach a wide cross-section of individuals in that location. That's a big part of our practice, determining where the performance is going to happen. And who we're speaking to. And so, at the beginning, we met people 45 minutes before we were to perform. We taught them how to do the performance. We gave them instructions for how to have their own voice and perspective inside of that. And then we went and performed for 45 minutes and documented that through the film and video. Now, it's on our little participant website.
saying,